I only got two more. Well, we've talked about the fire department and what they do for our community. Now we're going to talk about, real quick, where we're at right now. Where this is just, I'm going to have a couple of screens from our current budget. And anybody's welcome, as I said, I love props. Anybody's welcome to take it home with them tonight and read it. It'll put you to sleep real quick if you don't like numbers. But this is a fine work that we've been awarded. How many years in a row, Robert? 3 years now we've been awarded in financial. This was our first? This will be our second one, won't it? Second year that we've been awarded financial excellence awards on how we put our package together in the presentation. But our finance department does such a great job that when we get there to set our budget, that we have probably what used to be, when I first came on, a four-day work session usually. It's now a day, day and a half at the most for us to approve the budget. But as you can see from this screen here, on our revenue side, we got four major areas that we've always depended upon, and they're pretty prevalent. You know, it's our property taxes, insurance taxes, our utilities adding to our revenue, and then our payroll net profit tax make up a majority of our revenues that we have in our $25 million general operating budget for this year. We're going to go to the next one on the expense side, because that's probably the most important side of it, how we spend your money. That's what you're more worried about than anything else. As long as we don't raise your taxes, which we did not do this year. We did not raise property taxes. We took the compensating rate. We have not touched any of the other tax rates and any of the other revenue sources that we have. And sorry to say, we have tried to go and get, or I personally have been to Frankfort trying to look at other revenue sources that would alleviate some of these personal things where it's against your own property, against your insurance. We were trying to look at other avenues to raise funds along with other mayors I've met with. And it's just something that's going to take a while to convince Frankfort that there's maybe some other ways we need to look at it, because right now the city of Henderson has exhausted every revenue source avenue that they have as far as any other way to raise additional funds. Not to say we need to, because we do operate with what we have, and we're doing very good at it, but our hands are tied as far as if, and that's what's facing a lot of these other communities that you've got on that sheet. They have no way to look for any other money, and they've always looked for that federal handout, and now there's no federal handouts anymore. You know, stimulus is a four-letter word in Washington right now. But as far as this screen right here, you're seeing that the two departments I just talked mainly about, police and fire, our public safety departments represent 46.5% of our operating budget. That's why they are so important to our community and for our public safety. You know, it's the welfare of our community. But on the other hand of that, when you go on down through this, our entire salary and benefit package for the city of Henderson is 68.3% of the budget. A little over 68% is our salaries and benefits for our city payroll. But folks, when you think about what you're getting for your dollar in the city of Henderson, it's not hard to justify this, because the people are what make your city work. You know, the end product of the quality of life is what you're looking for, but this is what you're getting, is the people that are performing the jobs and the task in your community. So that's why it is over two-thirds of what it costs to operate your city out of its budget. But several things that have to do with that 68.3% are out of our control. That is the pension, which has been highly publicized, is probably one of the most expensive operational things for any of the cities in the state of Kentucky, and driving some of them toward bankruptcy. And I don't say that lightly. There are several cities in the state of Kentucky similar to our size that are facing that possibility in the next year to two if some remedies aren't done in Frankfort. And I think Dorsey can verify that, and so can David, that discussions about the pension plan and everything else that goes along with it, and the insurance plans, the KERS, CRS programs, are two of the most talked about costly things for the cities in the state of Kentucky. But we seem to be managing that. We're self-insured on our insurance. We had a catastrophic year this year with some major claims, but we've had such great experience coming up to that. So on probably a five-year annualized basis, we're still in good shape, and we will move forward next year with that. I think we'll be in fine shape. But we have 435 employees between the city, HWU, and Hempel. We've already talked about the dollars that are involved on budgets. They all deserve our praise. I want everybody that's an employee of the city of Henderson and HWU, Hempel, if you're on the board, Robert, I haven't formally introduced you, but my Commissioner Robert Pruitt, who already gave the blessing today, please stand up right now because you are the people that deserve the applause today, please. And Bobby, you join them. Stand up, Bobby. And the one lady I was encouraging to stand up with them, she's not directly a city employee, but it's another thing. When you talk about, I travel around the state of Kentucky and talk to other people about our city. Bobby Jarrett is the executive director of our housing authority. Folks, we have the best public housing authority in the state of Kentucky. Highest graded, highest recommended, and I'm not sure about total units that we manage right now across the board, because I've looked at several different reports. Bobby, how many units approximately we manage now? 1,079 units we're managing to give quality of life to people in Henderson. And that is, and that, she deserves a hand because they, so that's, and I'm proud to serve on that board of directors and watch her work. She just keeps Henderson in her heart.